here in the Hope College women's basketball postgame. Great comeback, just falls just a little bit short. Flying Dutch fall to Trine University 58-55. Here at DeVos Fieldhouse, Coach Brian Morehouse here with Francesca Buchanan and Kennedy Schoonveld. Coach, if you could begin with an opening statement.
Yeah, disappointed anytime we lose, but obviously a great atmosphere today, huge crowd. You know, felt like it was full in there. It was loud when we played and made our fans, gave them a reason to cheer. Unbelievable support. You know, I, as the head coach, I've got to accept a huge part of the responsibility of this loss. I mean, we weren't ready to play. You scored 14 points and a half. That's preparation, and I've got to own that as the head coach. And, you know, I'm trying to direct a group of 18 to 22-year-olds, and today I didn't do a very good job of it. So disappointed, lost to a really good team. You know, Amherst continues to win. Trine barely lost to them, the number one team in the nation. You know, disappointed that we lost, but I think as a measuring stick, I think Trine's pretty good, and I think we're pretty good. And you know, I think our we have a number of good teams in our league, but right now we're both at the top, and they fought back on our home court just like we beat them on their court to sort of even the ledger. And now it's going to be really important to you know, regroup, have great practice on Monday and Tuesday, and be ready to play on the road on Wednesday night.
Well, first half was tough. 14 points, not ideal. How were they able to kind of shut you guys down and keep you from getting buckets?
In my opinion, we missed shots. We didn't turn it over. We had 12 turnovers for the game. So we missed shots, number of shots in and out in the first half. I didn't think that we got to the free throw line very well in the first half. Pretty stagnant on offense. So I think it was they're one of the best defensive teams in the United States. You know, by the numbers, you know, when you watch them on video, you know, in every category that you would rank a team, you know, by the eye, by the numbers, they're one of the best defensive teams in the United States. And today, their defense was better than our offense, especially in the first half.
And Frankie, you had 4 points, not the most good-looking stat sheet for you in a while, but how were they able to kind of keep you guys from going inside and getting those buckets that you've been known to get for your career?
You know, I don't think they kept us from getting it inside. We got it inside a few times, and it's like Mo said, shots just weren't falling. We weren't getting to the free throw line very much, and you know, I mean, as a captain, I wish I could have led better and I could have gotten those shots, but I couldn't, and Kennedy stepped up in that position. It wasn't enough when our shots weren't falling.
And Kennedy, for you, late game, nearly late game heroics. You were just sinking some shots there, career high 24 points. What was working for you in that system? Was it just, hey, we need to come back and someone's got to get a spark here?
Yeah, I don't really know. I just didn't want to lose, really. That's what it came down to. So just chucking it up there, I guess.
Brian, was it the matter of finding her, or what was it that when we got her going and she provided that spark, you guys were able to do to get her in position to score and kind of lead the charge back?
Well, I thought Kennedy attacked the rim all day long. And so, I mean, six of her points came off of just going to the rim. I thought she got another one late in the game. You know, underneath the basket, she went baseline. I thought we were going to have an and one or at least two free throws. And, you know, instead we get the ball out of bounds, unfortunately. But, you know, I thought she was the most aggressive player. And the most aggressive player a lot of times gets rewarded. And I don't think she was in any way, shape, or form selfish. I think she was just aggressive. And she got other people good looks. I mean, she had a couple of assists today. And I thought she created, even when we missed them, she created open looks for other people with her aggressiveness. And so it wasn't so much what I drew up. It was people screening, Kennedy reading, and Kennedy, you know, attacking the rim and, you know, going through shot blockers and you know, making sure that she was going to get something out of the possession, whether it be a free throw or a made layup. Late in the game, I think she knocked down a couple great threes. We you know, ran a couple things for her, got her good looks. But you know, I think the late game heroics kind of overwhelm all the things that she did to keep us in the game throughout the whole game. And yeah, I mean, everyone wants to point towards the big three, you know, at the end. But I would point more towards how she played in the second and third quarter, super aggressively. She even got us started, I thought, early in the game with maybe our first bucket. And, you know, I think that we can take a good cue from her just in continuing to attack the basket and being a good passer for our teammates, finding people on open kickouts, and also attacking and getting fouled. So great game by Kennedy. You know, I think the other part is everybody wants to look at 24 points. But she did a heck of a good job on Dawson when we switched her off on her. And I thought Dawson still had a great day, but I think she had a tougher day when Kennedy was guarding her. And, you know, credit to her for playing both ends of the floor today. That's exhausting. I mean, she played 31 minutes, guarded Brandi Dawson for a huge part of that game, and still found a way to come up with 24 points.
Francesca, can you talk about the spark Olivia provided late in that run? She had a couple steals and some baskets, and that was big to kind of get you guys energized and going and nearly making this comeback.
Yeah, I agree. That really sparked our team, I think, and just those last few minutes of that third quarter and going into the fourth, seeing that, I think it got everybody on the bench energized, which kind of led the energy on the team and like who was playing on the court. It's always great to have such a deep bench. It's amazing. Those two post players, Ashley and Boss, they stepped up today. And yeah, the two steals that she had, man, we were hyped for them. And it did. It like built up a lot. And I think that's where a lot of the energy went for Kennedy, was seeing that and just all around the whole team, through the coaches, through the bench.
And Kennedy, obviously you're not surprised that Olivia can do that just because having played with her, but just talk about her performance, helping, just giving you guys an extra little boost there as you guys clawed your way back.
She's just a gritty player, hardworking player. And so we talked a lot in timeouts about needing to get that deny in the high post, and that's exactly what she did. Just worked hard and got those two steals and got the buckets. And yeah, like Frankie said, provided a huge spark for us. So yeah, no surprise, but because she's just so hardworking. But yeah.
Yeah. First loss of the season, you're experiencing the first loss as a college player, but you've been there before. With the younger team, how do you, as a leader, help to guide this younger team through a loss for the next game?
Yeah, I mean, we talked about it in the locker room. You get this weekend to kind of like get over it and get back to it on Monday and Tuesday. I almost said it earlier. Monday and Tuesday are going to be two great practices. You know, just like our little conversation with Mo, just kind of like, You have your head held like before he comes in, and when he comes in, it's just that much better. He talks you through it, and that it's an emotional roller coaster because all the freshmen are thinking like, oh, what could we have done? What we have done? And like the upperclassmen are just like, oh, what could we have done? And it's honestly a really tough thing to think about, because you think about yourself, you think about your team, and you're just like, you want to be like this person that can just step up and talk to everybody all at the same time. But when Mo left the locker room, we just kind of were in silent mode for a little bit, and then we all just kind of started talking, you know, like, what are we going to do to be better? We're going to talk about the knives, we're going to talk about like aggressiveness, our energy level, because you know we can get better in every realm of the game. So I think that was just like big thing that we were doing, is communication and just talking about what we did, what we can do to get better.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah.